life of separation, of alienation. So I try to tell them, look, you know, the end is near. We're almost out of this. The goal is upon us. You know, why don't you just start to eat, start to feel better, and, you know, we'll get you back doing something that will make you better. So Marty said, well, I don't really trust him. He's going to make me go back to the show ring and make me do a lot of classes every week, and I don't enjoy him anymore. That's why my ankles hurt, because I don't enjoy it anymore. I'm getting too old. Well, nobody wants to hear that they're hurting their horse, and nobody wants to do more than their horse wants them to do, but sometimes we don't really know what an athlete is feeling when we ask our animals to be athletic. So when I explained it to Marty's owner, whose name was Bill, when I explained it to Bill, he felt terrible. He's like, well, I don't mean to be disrespectful. I thought he was okay. That's why I sent him, you know, to this special facility. Tell him that. So I told the horse, and Marty said, oh, that actually makes me feel a lot better. I thought it was another thing where he was making me do what he wants to do, not what I want to do. And I thought, we've got trouble here. So I explained that to Bill, and Bill said, oh, I've heard this before. Everybody always complains that I do what I want to do, not what they want to do. That's what my wife said just before she left me. And then when he said that, he sort of surprised himself, because he just blurted it out. He was angry. He was in the middle of an ugly divorce, and he was super sad, and he was lonely. So in other words, he and Marty were feeling the same thing. They were missing their people. And so then he went on to blurt to me, well, I might as well just tell you this so you can explain it to the horse. My wife said that I always made too many lists. I worked too many hours. She didn't care about all the money I was making. She wanted her husband back, and she told me that for years and years. And I kept just buying her stuff and ignoring her. And she was lonely in her marriage, she said. I'm alienated. I'm alone. I don't have friends. I have no one. You're not around. So the horse, the man, wife, we're all feeling the same way. They lost each other somehow through this man's desire, probably to be successful, to make good money, to be responsible. They'd all sort of lost their joy of life, and that's why the woman thought, well, I keep asking for something I'm never going to get, so I guess I'm going to have to go somewhere else to get it. And so poor Bill, I mean, you know, he's like, my horse is jumping ship too. And I said, well, I think everybody's jumping ship, because maybe the ship isn't really, you know, sailing right. Maybe the ship is leading you to a place where you are lonely. And, you know, is this going to change? Are you going to have lost opportunity after lost opportunity for connection going forward? That's really what you need to ask yourself. Because the horse is pretty clear that unless he connects with you from a happiness place again, instead of sort of this impossible schedule of showing to achieve points to win more prizes, the woman doesn't want any more prizes either. She doesn't want any more fancy cars or bigger houses. The horse doesn't want more blue ribbons. He wants to feel like you're doing things because you like him. And he wants to be with his friends out in the field more. So, you know, maybe your choice, Bill, will be to either sell this horse and find a horse that's more, I don't know, interested in being a dedicated athlete. You know, athleticism day in and day out works for some bodies. For other bodies, it doesn't. That's why his ankles went the wrong way. Lots of other horses have this trouble. It's called suspensory injuries. They rehab, they go back to work, and they're happy as clams. But I said, Marty doesn't want to do it anymore. So Bill had to think about that. And he later on worked with me a few times, separate from Marty, to kind of analyze where he had perhaps been listening to his left brain more than his intuition, where he had been tuning out what might have felt good, like maybe having a nice quiet dinner with his wife at home instead of hopping on another plane and flying to another city to make another deal. Or maybe just taking his horse out for a quiet ride around the farm and only showing less frequently. And sort of taking all of his goals and maybe scaling him down to a place where he still felt connected to his wife, whom he loved dearly, connected to his children, who he stopped seeing because he was too busy, and connected to his horse, who really just wanted companionship from him, but had given up on it a long time ago, because the guy used to fly in, get on the horse, show him, fly back out, go to whatever business meeting he needed to meet, because he was successful. Which, success is wonderful, but your definition of success, of course, needs to be always considered. In other words, What feels good? Was he happy every time he got on that plane? He said no, he wasn't, and that's what we talked about. He'd lost the ability to stay in the process. Again, I keep repeating this idea, but he forgot to adjust to what would make him feel safe, to like enough money, what would make him feel happy. After a while, how much money do you need to feel safe? This man had tons of it. So he didn't really need it for that reason anymore. So maybe he should have somewhere along the line started to modify his lifestyle so that he could incorporate happy and not base everything on his past ideals, goals, and targets. So again, an animal was showing him, I'm so unhappy, I don't even care about eating anymore. I've lost my joy, I've lost my appetite for life. And from that, it was very interesting how he ended up keeping Marty. He bought another younger horse that was totally into showing and was totally loved the more of the circuit, which kept Bill practicing more and more into what he liked to do. He kept Marty. He showed him a little bit. He trail rode him, kept him at his home farm, and tried to rebuild his life based more on the ideals of well, joy instead of what was responsible or what a good man should do, which is make as much money as you can make until you drop. So we can take any conflicting responsibilities that we feel in our lives, two ideas where we think, I should be responsible or I should be maybe just do what feels right. And often the self-care choice, the thing that is the answer of what feels better, the thing that an animal would pick would be to do the thing that feels better. Usually, if you pick that, it will lead you, because intuition is very interesting this way. Intuition leads you to the next step of the thing you haven't considered yet. And from there's like this joy of discovery that happens, because it's like an idea drops down and you think, well, why didn't I think to do that? Just give the horse a year off, throw him in the field, let him be happy with his friends, he'll start eating again, I'll go do something else. And from that, something different could bloom from this relationship instead of forcing the horse back to doing what he didn't really want to do, which he knew the horse actually didn't really want to do it anymore. He said the horse had stopped acting happy a couple months before he actually hurt himself. He was just tired of being an athlete and on the road all the time. And so animals as our intuitive tutors is a very lovely assignment for you to be thinking about. Ask your animal this next month, well, what could I learn from you? Like, you seem to have your life down pretty well. Instead of thinking I have to change my animal, what could they show you better about what you could change about you? What could they show you to make you happier about you? So thank you so much for joining me, and I'm very, very honored to have been able to do this show today. And my name is Laura Rowley, and you're listening to Animal Connections with Laura Rowley on Syndicated Dream Vision 7 Radio Network. Every Friday at 9 a.m. or 9 p.m. Eastern Time. You can listen online or on your mobile devices. To learn more and for a full schedule, go to dreamvision7radio.com. Dream Vision 7 Radio Network is the media partner for Omega Institute.
Thank you for joining Animal Connections with Laura Rowley. Heard every Friday at 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. Eastern Time on Dream Vision 7 Radio Network. Join Laura next time to discover how you can embrace the wisdom flowing from your loved animals. Communication starts with an intention to understand. Each week, Laura helps you find your own unique ability to create a better understanding of yourself as taught through the loving eyes of your animals. To connect with Laura Rowley, go to laurarowleyhealer.com. That's LaurarowleyHealer.com.
This is Dream Vision 7 Radio Network, uniting mankind with universal love. Our shows are created from the heart, bringing each listener to a place of divine enlightenment. Breathe, relax, and enjoy. Let life flow.